What happens when you combine Harry Potter, J.K. Rowling, and Israel together?
The Middle East is in chaos.
Facing this stuff in real life.
Here, in Israel.
When you're a second away from being murdered or watching a friend die right before your eyes.
So it would appear there's another shtickler who will put together some Harry Potter clips together with some audio of Israel and come up with a great montage, which was all over Facebook this week.
I'm afraid the minister will do almost anything to avoid facing that terrifying truth.
So according to you, Cedric Diggory dropped dead of his own accord?
They have their personal biases at play here.
Cedric Diggory's death was a tragic accident.
It was murder. Voldemort killed him. You must know that. Enough!
Hamas, to its eternal shame, did more to deliberately and systematically inflict death, suffering, and destruction than any other terrorist group in history. And the response from nearly every one of the governments represented here has been absolutely nothing.
The unintended consequences that would come with war means that we have to do everything we can to try to resolve this diplomatically.
Sorry about him. He doesn't understand what it's like.
How can you tell people to stop defending themselves?
Keep calm.
It's completely unfair.
You've done nothing wrong.
Also, coincidentally, and just literally at the same time, J.K. Rowling was signing up with 149 other signatories to an anti-boycott divestment campaign ad over in the UK. She basically said that she believed that cultural boycott singling out Israel are divisive and discriminatory and will not further peace. Cultural engagement basically builds bridges. It doesn't tear people apart. So with the many, many different lists of people saying we shouldn't support Israel, there is at least one very successful and very highly respected writer who says otherwise. Sunday the 15th of November is Mitzvah Day. It's worldwide, not just here in Melbourne, Australia, but across the globe. It's an opportunity for people of all colours and creeds to do things for others, perhaps that they wouldn't necessarily normally do. So it might be giving blood, or perhaps just fixing up a garden for someone. Or it could be something even more important.
It's a long-term investment.
It's an impetus for change in individual people's lives.
That's how the friendship starts, you know, and the bridges are built.
It may be called mitzvah, it may be called a'malul khayriya, it may also be known as love thy neighbor.
We must be true to our faith and yet a blessing to others regardless of their faith.
So you can probably tell from my pasty face condition that I'm an Ashkenazi Jew. Unlike the colourful Sephardic community, I descend from the cold winters of Russia and Poland. Russia on my father's side, Poland on my mother's side. Many people will be unaware, though, that there were 3 million Jews in Poland living perfectly well and happily before the Second World War. We recognise many of the faces that we see in footage from pre-war Poland because there's so many similarities. When we look around the synagogues, both in Europe, Australia and America, we will see the faces of generations of families. Sadly, no longer with us, but certainly worth connecting with, as we will do in the following story. I love watching movies about Jewish history, and The Pianist is one of the best examples of that. The story of Ladislaw Smilsman, a Polish-Jewish pianist, who was playing live on the radio in Warsaw when the station was bombed as Germany invaded Poland. His story of survival is one that has to be seen to be believed, but it inspires so many Jews around the world today to continue to fight for their existence. And to retain their identity, just as so many Jews were made to wear their armband. So today I feel like I should be wearing that armband for them. Their stories are told best in the extraordinary museums across the world, the Holocaust Museum. And whilst the Holocaust is such an important part of our history, it is but 5 years. Whereas Poland and its thousand-year history has so, so much more to tell.
Nie da się zrozumieć i w pełni przeżyć historii Polski bez znajomości historii Żydów polskich. Wynika to nie tylko z wielowiekowej obecności Żydów na naszych ziemiach, ale i ze znaczenia społeczności żydowskiej w wielu dziedzinach polskiego życia, w gospodarce, w kulturze, w nauce.
גם אם נותקו היהודים מפולין, הרי שקשה עד בלתי ניתן לנתק את פולין מהיהודים. אי אפשר למחוק היסטוריה עשירה כל כך, מלאה כל כך, כואבת כל כך. המוזיאון היהודי, שאת ארוחת הקבע שלו אנו חונכים היום, מנסה להציג את ההיסטוריה היהודית בפולין על כל צדדיה. על אושרה ועל עונייה, על חסידיה ומתנגדיה, על משכיליה ופשוטי העם שבה, על יחסי השכנות, על ההיסטוריה השמחה והטרגית שלה. זהו לא מוזיאון שואה, זהו מוזיאון חיים. זהו מקום אשר מנציח את מה שהיה, את מה שכבר לא יהיה, ואת התקווה. התקווה לעתיד אחר.
Jestem całkowicie przekonany, ja jestem pewny, że gdy ja mówię mir zene do, jesteśmy tutaj, usłyszę odzew wielu wspaniałych ludzi. Jesteśmy z tobą. Jesteśmy z wami. Myślę, że to również, a może przede wszystkim, symbolizuje nasze muzeum.